They are the ones who sacrifice their time, their effort, and everything in their life just to lift up the name of our Lord Jesus. Let us all welcome the mini concert, Holy Week presentation of JIL Area 5 featuring the seven last words of Jesus.
Condemned, and I'm alive and well. Child. Hello, pre.
Oo, sige.
Oo, sabi ko yung naman mamaya. O, sige. Sige, sige.
Ma, ano yung miss ko? Bakit 450?
Grinch ka na naman nakita mo. Wala ka naman talaga ang ibang alam gawin, kundi pakialaman ang buhay ko. Kabutihan? Kapakanan? Wow! Kung kabutihan mo, iniisip mo, nasaan ka ng mga panahon na kailangan kita?
Anak?
Nasaan ka para ipagpanggol ako? Di ba wala? Nasaan ka kapag pinanggubuli sa akin?
Mark.
Wala ka. Ilang birthdays ko hindi mo na-attendan? Hindi ko na nga mabilang eh. Tapos sasabihin mo, kapakanan ko, iniisip mo? Wala kang alam sa nararamdaman ko. Wala kang alam sa nararamdaman ng isang anak. Nang isang anak na namumuli na sa yarap ng ina. Nang isang anak na namumuli na sa aruga ng ina. Alam mo ba kung anong sinasabi sa akin mga kaklase ko? Sinasabi sa akin na putok ako sa muho. Siguro nga totoo. Siguro nga totoo. Kasi kahit ako, simula pagkabata ako, hindi pa kita nakita ng personal. Tapos sasabihin mo, kapag anak mo iniisip mo, wala kang alam sa nararamdaman ko.
Ngayon ba tingin mo, anak? Napapahasarap ako dito? Siguro nga, Mark! Hindi ko alam lahat ng hirap na pinagdaanan mo.
Kaya talaga alam.
Pero naisip ko rin ba lahat ng hirap mo? Naisip ko rin ba lahat ng pagtitiis ko? Lumayo ako dahil gusto mo. Lumigyan ka ng magandang kinabukasan. Sa mga panahon na mamuli na ako, anak. Ang gusto ko lang magdalawa.
Bakit? Tinanong mo ba ako kung gusto kong malayo sa'yo? Di ba, hindi? Tinanong mo ba ako kung gusto ko na maraming ang buhay? Pero malayo sa aruga at sa piling ng ina.
I know it's tough. I know hindi ganun kadali ang mag-adjust sa Canada.
But not because you're having problems right now, it means na God has never abandoned you. It doesn't mean that God has forgotten you. I know He has a reason. Baka gusto lang yung mo siya, or mayroon siya gustong ituro sa'yo. O kaya naman, gagamitin ka pa niya pag na-overcome mo to. I don't know the reason, but anuman, whatever the reason is, one thing I know, that He loves you so much that He died for you. So is it okay na ipag-bring na kita ngayon? It's never too late to go back to Him. So let's just pray. Lord, we thank You for this wonderful day that You have given us. Thank You for the opportunity to talk and pray for Mark. Lord, You know the condition of his heart. You know him well. And I believe You have plans for him. Lord, whatever his whatever the circumstances are, I believe it will all be finished. Kapag tatagumpayan yung lahat ng iyon. And today, we are surrendering Mark's life to You. We are surrendering our lives, our problems, and burdens to You, Lord God. And we make the victory that everything will be finished, from God. We start praying. Just stay with prayer. Amen.
Mark, nandiyan ka na pala. Anak, may gusto ka bang kainin? Sandali, pagluluto muna kita. Hain mo lang pagkain, ma.
Ma, isa sumisa ka sa iyo.
Hindi na, anak.
Ma, gusto ko sana humingi ng tawad. Gusto ko sana humingi ng tawad sa lahat ng pagkukulang ko bilang anak, ma. Gusto ko sana humingi ng tawad sa mga mali na gawa ko sa iyo. Gusto ko sana humingi ng tawad, ma.
Nakatawag ka, Tara. Ikaw lang hinihintay ko. Masaya pa sa akin sa manangyari. Mahal na mahal ka ni Lord, anak. Mahal na mahal kita.
Lord, salamat po. Salamat po sa pagkilos mo sa buhay namin. Salamat po dahil ikaw ang Diyos. Ikaw ang Diyos na kong pinipuan na bubaba ng buhay. Salamat po dahil napagsagupan ako na. Thank you, Lord.
by tradition lamang? Ito ba by history lamang? Or there is a big significant and effect to our life as we celebrate the death of the Lord Jesus Christ on the cross. His suffering, the last seven last word in the cross before He died. What is the really the reflection of it in our life? The Lord suffering in the cross and His death. Let make a story a reality in our life. Not only a history, let's make it a reality to our life. Because there is a reason why He died there on the cross. And I believe the main reason of it, for us a human being, to receive forgiveness of our sin as we acknowledge what He did in the cross, and then He promised He will forgive our sin, and as you accept Him as your Lord and personal Savior, and then He will bring you to paradise in heaven. Amen? In this account of the last few minutes of the Lord Jesus Christ on the cross, we see that He is very much willing to finish His mission of saving all human creation that He loved. Salvation is just for human being, but there is there are 7 billion creation here on earth. So, the application of John 3:16 is not for other kind of creation. It is only applied for you and for me. First boy, Father, forgive them, for they don't know what they are doing. Luke 23:34, this message of forgiveness. He is the perfect example of forgiveness. We receive forgiveness, so we must forgive others. Okay? The best boy, Father, forgive them, for they don't know what they are doing. This message of forgiveness, He is the perfect example of forgiveness. Okay? We receive forgiveness as we humble ourselves, acknowledge that we sin. Anyway, all of us sin, and the wages of sin is death. So we need to ask forgiveness. Okay? And also, we must forgive others. Second word, I assure you today, you will be with me in paradise. Luke 23:43. The assurance of salvation that God is giving to the criminal is the same assurance of salvation that He is giving us today to your life. He will bring us to paradise in heaven. All of us sin, and the wages of sin is death. And Hebrews said, man is destined to die once and after that judgment. After this life here on earth, there is another life. Only two destinations of life, hell and heaven. God so loved the world, He came here on earth to die on the cross so that you will not go, we will not go to hell. He wants us to be in His place, a good place to stay forever, which is paradise. He said to the criminal, I will bring you to paradise. Dear boy, dear woman, here is your son. John 19:26. Even the cross, Jesus is so concerned about His responsibility to His Father. Jesus is showing us to be responsible in our relationship. The fourth word, my God, why have you abandoned me? Mark 15:34. Because all our sin was carried by Jesus, have you taken time to consider that Jesus was abandoned by the Father so that you might not be? My God, have you abandoned me? God, the Father in heaven, He cannot look upon the life of the Lord Jesus Christ dead on the cross because He carried all our sins so that we can establish the right relationship to the Father. Have you taken time to consider that Jesus was abandoned by the Father so that you might not be? What does this word from the cross mean to you? Meaning Jesus was forsaken so that you will not be forsaken. God will never leave you nor forsake you. The big word, I am thirsty. John 19:28. Jesus is literally thirsty. But this account is the fulfillment of the word of God in Psalm 69:20-21. Their insult have broken my heart, and I am in despair. If only one person would show some pity, if only one would turn and comfort me, but instead they give me a poison for food they offer me sour wine for my tears. Psalm 69, 20 to 31. John 4:10, Jesus, the living water that leads us to eternal life. Because even though he said, I am thirsty, because, but see, he is, Jesus is the satisfaction of our life here on earth. I'm telling you, without Jesus, you are nothing, we are nothing. He is the only satisfaction of our life here on earth. Only in the Lord Jesus Christ. Though he said, I am thirsty. The sixth word, it is finished. John 19:30. Yeah, it is finished. We are victorious. Do you live as if Jesus finished the work of salvation? It is finished already. No religion can save us. Even Jesus' Lord Church cannot save us. Because religion is not the one who finished the work of salvation, but only Jesus Christ, our Savior. He said, it is so no religion can save. Only personal relationship to the Savior. As we humble yourself, acknowledge that you sin before Him, and confess your sin, and ask forgiveness, and believe what He did in the cross is just enough for us to salvation. No religion can save. The seventh last word. The seventh word is, Father, I entrust my spirit into your hands. Luke 43, 46. Sabi po doon, the Lord Jesus knew that his earthly body is going to die, and he knew that his spirit is much important than his body. So he commit his spirit to God. Jesus knew his spirit is much important than the body. The message is commitment. Commitment of our life and our spirit to God. Everything in our life, we must entrust to God. For we cannot do anything without God in our life. And this is practical. Today, as we celebrate Easter week, ito po sa conclusion, let it be a reminder to us that on that moment in the cross, Jesus gave us a message that we need to do. And in the cross, we saw the meaning of our existence here on earth. We are not defeated, but we are always victorious. John 3:16 is very clear. For God so loved the world, he gave his one and only Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life.